You're welcome back to The Pulse. And just before we go, let me bring you this story. It's a case of acquiring knowledge through the benevolence of the states, but being deprived of the ultimate, the certificate which is proof of academic achievement. That's the story of Nukunu Etonam Achiabobi, who has completed a first degree course in biological science at the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology. Now, she is one of the many who benefited under the master's scholarship organized by the Environment, Science and Technology Ministry. She has been narrating her ordeal to join us as Jifa Kege.
I'm Etonam and I'm on the master's scholarship. I got it through my dad when he applied for the scholarship. It was supposed to cover for the duration of my stay in KNUST, and they are supposed to pay 600 Ghana cedis every academic year to cover for just tuition. But they paid only once. That was when I was in second year. That was for 2013-2014 academic year. And since then, they haven't made any payments till now. So I just recently graduated, and it's required that I clear my arrears before the school clears me and gives me my certificate. So that's the problem right now.
When you were moving from level 200 to 300, yeah, what were school authorities saying? They were not bothered about you not paying school fees, yet they were promoting you?
Oh, they were worried. It made registration every semester very hectic, because you have to move from one account office to the another, carrying your letter around to show that you are on scholarship, and make them promises that they would pay. So it got to a time, one semester I was almost not registered because my arrears had piled up and the accountant wasn't registered ready to clear me to allow me to register. So it made registration in the school very difficult. For this academic year, when I was just about to graduate, we had to pay about half of the money. We had to find some money to pay about half. Otherwise, they wouldn't have registered me for 2015-2016 academic year. Yes, so it really caused a lot of stress on my parents trying to get all the money together.
On what basis do you become a beneficiary?
They look at your grades, and if it's good, then they give you the scholarship. They state that you are entitled to an amount of 600 Ghana cedis every academic year. So the years that the school fees became more than 600, mm-hmm, we have to top up. Yes, that's what we do. Okay. But it makes things much better, because if I'm to pay 700 and you are giving me 600, that means I just have to find 100 cedis. My main concern is that I'm not the only person on the master's scholarship. Usually when I go to the accounts office at the beginning of the semester, I meet other beneficiaries and we are always there, and it's made like life in the beginning of the semester very difficult. So I'd want them to try and find a way to make this whole system more efficient, so that students won't be suffering every semester just because we are on scholarship.